I'm Cody Benjamin, author of Why We Need the Movies and Movies from the Mountaintop. Today, we're going inside Red Wing Cinema 8 for a local spotlight and a behind-the-scenes look at an ever-evolving industry.
Hi, my name is Jesse Stewart. I am the general manager of Red Wing Cinema 8 here in Red Wing, Minnesota, and I've been doing this for about 14 years.
A lot goes on back here during the weekends, especially. Sometimes it gets a little messy back here. So popcorn. Our popper is right here. We have two of these. Handy room, or supply room. What we do is we'll take some of the stuff individually, put on the candy cart, so it's a little easier for us to restock concession stands. And this is our popping oil back here. That stuff has to be heated, otherwise it hardens like a block of butter. And the butter is already liquid, so you don't really need to have that heated, although we do have a heating element underneath the counters out there.
Okay.
So that the butter is warm. We get usually posters months in advance for movies that come out or that are going to be coming out. And a lot of times we get like a teaser poster and then we get a final art poster. A lot of people don't know that. Oh, this is this. And then when it actually comes out, oh, it's a different artwork. It's kind of cool. Frames here on the framing just pops out like that.
And
I have, yes, gotten my fingers stuffed in it. And it does hurt. Very much so. But here we go. We're going to head up here. Projection room. The projection room. This is where the magic happens.
Yeah.
As they say. And of course, this is basically right above the hallway downstairs. The hallway goes all the way down, all eight projectors. So when we get movies in, we'd get them in either cans, like two or three cans, or a one big, like a hard plastic box. And we'd get them on these. And each movie was averaged between 6 and maybe 8 reels, depending on the length. So like Titanic was 13, Avatar was 13.
Wow.
So you gotta splice them all together. And this is how we do that. So this is actual film, this is a trailer. But if you look, you can see that blue strip on the side.
Yep.
That's where the sound is.
Okay.
And a little laser in the projector would play that off, and that's how that, and they're all like squiggly lines, kind of almost like a needle in a groove of record vibrates, so it kind of does that. So we get these in, it was always like a little multicolored line, and you'd have to find that, take this, put that there, and we'd have to clip that off on here, and that was where you'd splice it. Then you would take that, put it in the middle of that line right there, and you would have to take the next part of film. You take tape like this, put it over, do this, push it down, and what this does is put holes in the tape where the projector teeth go. Do that, and then do the other side so that it would maintain multiple plays. It would take about an hour to build a movie and about 20 minutes to tear them apart. I miss it so much. With digital now, we get them on a hard drive, and I can show you what those look like. Get in these little boxes like this. So there's four slots, and you can download four movies at a time. And they go in, they pop up on the screen, and we start downloading them after we label each file as it's downloading. And this process takes about, I don't know, 30 minutes per movie. And this would be like our local ads. The Coke ads we get once a month. So Coke ads are right on there, and they're also labeled. I just label all the movies, put them up here so I know when they're leaving which one to take. After everything's downloaded, we get keys in via email. And then what we do is we put them on a thumb drive like this downstairs from our emails. And they're basically little codes is what they are. And they unlock the movies. And then if we don't get a new key for it, it means we're not showing it after a certain date because they do expire. It's to cut down on piracy. We could take this down and check for clarity, sound, all that stuff.
So it's pretty rare then where someone's actually up here nowadays when a movie's starting. Okay.
Yeah, almost never happens.
Yeah. So
we're up here twice a day. Huh. Turn things on, turn things off. Yeah. Screens are the same size for all eight auditoriums. And so all the speakers, if you want to take a look here, you can see the holes.
See that? That's so the sound can get through. That's nothing to do with picture.
this theater's history of its CAB theaters?
CAB yeah. theaters, yep.
Okay, so...
That stands for Chris, Amber, Bella, and Beau. So Amber is Chris and Amber, husband and wife, and their kids are Bella and Beau. So being here, I think when people are shopping, when we're popping the popcorn, people can smell it outside. So a lot of people will just come in and just get popcorn.
Really?
Oh, I was shopping over at Maurice's and I could smell the popcorn.
And they come and buy a bag?
they do. I have a lady that comes in and buys two of them almost every week.
Really?
Yeah. We appreciate being supported.
Yeah. You know,
especially after the pandemic. We closed twice and reopened each time. And that was scary. You know, the world's been through hell and back. It's just, I think people really do appreciate what we still have.
So how did you, besides just selling a bunch of bags of popcorn, how are we still here?
We are, it's getting better. It's really getting better. I've noticed a huge change. Movies make a difference, you know, depending on the movies. There were some programs out there to help movie theaters. You had to apply for stuff, you know, as you, any kind of thing, you got to apply for grants. And so that did help.
We're just past the 1 year anniversary of Top Gun Maverick coming out. How much did that movie rebuild the audience locally here?
Oh, crazy.
Yeah.
It was crazy. I had at least three people that came and saw the movie more than five times.
Five?
Yeah. Same with Harry Potter. Harry Potter, the last two films were insane. People dressed up. People were just, it felt like an event. They were either sitting outside, lined up, ready to go, in their costumes. You know, it really felt like they were going to a concert. You know, in a town like Red Wing, it's, you know, it just depends. Summertime, it seems like 9 o'clock's do okay.
At night?
Yeah. Okay. Because it doesn't really get dark now until like 9:30.
Yeah.
So it's mostly teenagers.
Yeah.
And it's usually the scary movies, you know, that they're drawn to. So right now you see a lot of little girls coming in dressed up with Little Mermaid costumes on, and you know, and I love that. I think that's great. I love it. Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Got some boys coming in dressed up as Spider-Man.
Really?
It's really cool. Yeah, I love it.
I think maybe it's it's like a misconception almost. I think that younger people now don't go to the movies. But you're saying even in a town of this size, families with young kids or even adolescents, like, they're still coming here? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you say
some of them that were this tall are now working here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have a lot of dedicated people, customers that come in still. They're regulars. I know their orders. I know, you know, it's just like if you're going to a restaurant or something. I know your order. Is that what you want? What, the usual?
Yeah.
Kind of thing. And it's I love that camaraderie feeling, that warm, fuzzy, like, we're a community together. We come together and stick together. Having, you know, grown up here and lived here my whole life, I really think it's, I love it.
I talked to, there was an executive for Imagine Entertainment.
Yes.
So he was saying that you kind of hope for a 12-year cycle where every 12 years you almost need a big reinvestment or renovation. Do you find that, like, are you immune to that because you're in a small community, or what is the next kind of upgrade, even if it's a long way off, for Red Wing Cinema?
Seats.
The luxury recliners, the full food menu, is that on the horizon here?
It is.
Okay.
It is. I can't get into too many specifics right now, but it sounds like it's going to for sure happen in early 24.
That's big news, I feel like.
That is big news, yeah. That's the plan. It's almost kind of like showing our community too, like, hey, we're still here. We thank you for your support. We do want to make your experience just a little better. It's the experience. I think being social is really important to the human soul. I think it's just so important. You know, you need your downtime at home. I get it. But for me, that's kind of the big thing too, is just being social.
Like you said, it's the getting out, it's the being
it
in
is,
the community,
really.
But it's also, I think there's so much more focus. When you come in here, it's one of the last places in society where you are turning off your phone and you're just focusing on something. Have you ever had any celebrity guests at this theater?
Tim Allen.
Okay.
Absolutely.
At what point?
I think we still had film and we were showing X-Men First Class.
Okay.
And he was, that later that night, was going to perform at Treasure Island. for a stand-up thing. And so him and his opening act buddy came in. It was in this theater, actually.
Really?
Yeah. Came in, and I was upstairs, and I was doing projection.
They were here to see X-Men?
X-Men First Class.
Okay.
I don't know if they were just killing some time before they had to perform. Okay. And someone called up to me and said, yes, I think Tim Allen is in the building. I'm like, get out of here. Why would he be? And then it hit me. I'm like, oh my God, he's performing at Turner's Island. What's he doing in a movie?
Right.
I mean, it's great.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. I came down and I said, I will offer to clean theaters. Someone else can go upstairs. I will offer to clean theaters. And I came down and then he was coming out and I said, hey, Mr. Allen, it's nice to meet you. I hope you enjoyed the movie and whatnot.
You sound like Buzz Lightyear?
He did.
Okay.
He did.
Okay.
He did a little bit. And one of my employees actually said to him, do you know, you look a lot like Tim Allen. And his response was, yeah, it's funny, isn't it? That's it. That's all he said.
Oh, man. Is there anything else that you, like, want people to know? Like, people who, whether they're regular customers, whether they've never been here, anything else that you want them to know?
There's a lot that goes into this you wouldn't think.
Yeah.
Because it's a movie theater, all you just hit play. No, there's more to it than that. I like going to places and enjoying myself. Doesn't matter where it's at. Restaurant, doesn't matter. I want people, you know, I want people to be, treat people how you want to be treated.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
Yeah.
And just be thankful that we're here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it could have ended badly.
Yeah. Okay, so
great working environment. I love the people I work with. And it's nice because everybody jokes around with each other. I like to push the lever, it's fun. I get the, I'm at a factory, you know?
See, the lids, don't forget the lids.
Oh, the lids! We used to have like awful lids, but now we got the good ones, and it's, you know, actual icy lids and cups.
They're not spilling out.
And they, and the icy don't taste better. The icies taste better in the icy cups. They do. No, have you tried it?
Yes. It's
no, that's gonna be the highlight of the.
I know.
Yep. It's the biggest highlight of the hallway.